You told me something earlier about what the NFL requires all 32 teams to have. You're one for the city of New Orleans and the Saints. What is that when it comes to the position that's required to be on the field for something like what happened here in Cincinnati?
Yeah, so the NFL mandates that every team in the NFL has what they call an airway management physician. And the overwhelming majority of us in the league are ER physicians, board certified emergency medicine physicians. And our primary role and responsibility is if one of the players either stops breathing or their heart stops beating.
And if you could talk about this, it's a tragic situation, what's happening with the Buffalo player, what happened in Cincinnati last night. But you and other doctors around the league are trained for this exact situation. This did not catch anybody off guard. This is the training that you go through during the preseason.
Yeah, obviously, I don't have any insight into what actually occurred last night. However, what little bit I was able to see on TV, it was very obvious that they implemented the protocols or standard operating procedures that we already have in place across the league. And the NFL really had a lot of foresight, fortunately, and created this airway management position many, many years ago. So I've been with the Saints now for 12 seasons in this role. And in the off season, we actually train. We have the entire medical staff for the Saints. We have our EMS partners, myself, at the training facility or the practice facility on Airline Highway, and we actually go through mock scenarios. And we do that either with a mannequin or a simulation mannequin or an actual live person who's simulating a player. And one of the scenarios that we actually train for is cardiac arrest on the field. And watching what happened last night, it was very obvious that they were well trained, prepared, and followed the protocol that was in place in order to resuscitate that player in a timely fashion.
Because look, I mean, it's been said over and over again. Football is important, but it's fun. This is life or death. The football point is no longer important here. It's about a young player's life here. Talking about what you saw on TV and the training that you get from being on NFL fields, this is a life-saving situation for those medical first responders right there that responded yesterday.
No doubt. And in fact, we find that through training and preparation, we are ready for these scenarios when they occur. Obviously, and in fact, I pray before every kickoff before the game, that we never run into a scenario like this. However, we know we're prepared for it. And so, in an event such as the one that occurred last night, we immediately go to the player and assess the player. And when they recognize that the player was unresponsive, the next step was to check to see if they were breathing and whether their heart was beating or they had a pulse. And it's very clear, just from the little bit that I was able to see on TV, that there was a sense of urgency. And then I saw my counterpart for the Cincinnati Bengals, that the airway management physician for their team, actually go out to the player, after which our view was occluded. But it was very clear that they had an issue that was emergent, that was ongoing. And then, on television, we obviously heard that CPR was in progress, at which point it was very clear to me that this was something primarily cardiac and that they would need to resuscitate this player before transporting. And so once they were able to transport the patient, when you saw the ambulance take the player away and they weren't performing CPR at that point, it was obvious that they had return of spontaneous circulation or the player's heart had started beating again.
Is that good news? I mean, as a physician, like I said, I know we don't want to speculate because obviously this is a developing story minute by minute, but from what you saw and what you just said, is that a positive if they were able to resuscitate him and get him to a hospital?
Oh, no doubt. I think that historically, prior to having AEDs and or defibrillators on site at sporting events, the player would have 100% passed away. The death rate for cardiac arrest at a sporting event was essentially 100% prior to implementation of medical protocols that we now have in place and innovation that we have. And so the fact that he was on the field and medical personnel were right there, and we had the equipment necessary to be able to administer medications if necessary or electrical defibrillation if necessary, whatever they actually did was ultimately life-saving.
How serious? Final question here, doctor. I mean, look, we're all used to watching sports and we're seeing hits that look jarring and broken bones and torn ligaments. This is not something you see all the time. You know, for people of a certain age, and we're in our 40s, we talked about this morning, the Hank Gathers situation back in 1989 with Loyola Marymount, when it was a cardiac arrest type situation. If you could just walk us through how uncommon something like this is to happen anywhere. Look, if it happened in your office building or mine, it would catch people off guard. It would be a jarring situation. But the fact that a cardiac incident happened on a football field on national TV.
We take training very seriously. We prepare for scenarios like this with the understanding that the overwhelming majority of us will never encounter a scenario like that, which occurred last night. In the emergency department setting, as I'm an ER physician, it happens all the time, right? And it's not surprising. But seeing it on TV last night jarred me, right? I remember the feeling that I had as soon as I saw the sense of urgency on the medical staff side. And then when they surrounded the player, it was very clear to me that there was something serious going on. Hearing the commentators start mentioning CPR, I had chills. I started thinking about it and running through my head all of the scenarios, the mock scenarios that we had been training for the many years that I've been with the Saints organization as a contracted independent physician. And I could rest on the fact that it appeared like they were prepared, similar to the way that we are prepared. But nonetheless, no matter how much preparation you have, from an emotional perspective, it's very difficult to conceptualize something like this until it's happening. And so, you know, I'm obviously thankful that the player is still living and that they were able to resuscitate him and that he made it to the hospital alive. And it sounds like at this point he's still alive. And so that's obviously a great scenario.